closer to the fire. Don't be shy. It's okay. We're all going to get to know each other here. Yes. Hello. 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 Welcome to my humble abode. Well, not really, actually. I wish it was. Wouldn't this be nice? In the, like, Hollywood Hills. Got a mansion up in here. Downtown Los Angeles. Yes. It would be very nice. But no. No, 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 no. I'm an actor. That's not... We don't get to afford... Most of us don't get to afford such things. I know, right? But in here, look at this. This is nice. Yes, right? And the fire, very beautiful. Well, really beautiful illusion. But it works. It does the job. It does the job. How's everybody doing? Feeling good? Feeling good? Yes. Surviving, healthy, happy. Good, good. That's wonderful. Oh, excellent. Yes, this is an interactive show, so I'm going to be talking to you. Oh, hi there. Hey, what's up? Yeah, come on in. Hang out. I'm going to be talking to you. We're going to be getting to know each other. Get ready, okay? Participation is happening. Yes. You're like, I'm here for it. I'm here. I'm with you, my friend. Thank you. I like it. These are the words an actor likes to hear. Excellent. Well, 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 well. Here we are. The beginning. Beginning. Yes. Well, this feels very old school, doesn't it? Gathered around a fire, hanging out with folks. Sharing our stories and our troubles and our woes. And in fact, it is. It's sort of the oldest story in the book, or the original book. The Decameron, oldest novel in the world. Oh, don't jump, my friend. We like you. Stay with us. It is pretty, though. Don't leave us. Yes, we like you. Don't go over the edge. It's too soon. I haven't even started the story yet. My gosh. Wow, that's a review if I ever had one. Oof. Rough. Okay. Anyway, as I was saying, the oldest story in the world is the Decameron, and it's all about a group of young people gathered around a fire, telling stories to pass time during the bubonic plague. Which, you know, feels oddly appropriate in this day and age, right? Here we are, gathered around a fire, we're going to be sharing some stories, and, well, the plague is still a plague. Let's be honest here. The theaters are closed, right? Just like back in the medieval times where they closed the theaters because they didn't want people congregating and things like that. It all comes round again. It all circles and cycles and swirls and spirals in the sands of time. You know, the waves roll in and they roll out. That is true. Absolutely, yes. Well, stories. Most stories, I think, start with a truth, or they work best when they're based on the truth. And mine is that I'm an actor in Los Angeles. Hello, my name is Witten. How are you all? Yes, anyone else from LA, West Coast? Nobody West Coast? All right, East Coast? No, East Coast, middle of the country. Yes, all right. Europe! And lands afar afield. Excellent! Yes, welcome! Oh, wonderful! Oh, fantastic! Great, mixed bunch. Last show, I had all Americans. It was interesting. It's very strange. So, cool. Yeah, so I'm an actor, and before all of this mishigas, all of the craziness, I was set to be in a production of The Tempest. I was very excited. I was cast as the lead, as Prospero, the magician. Tempest, Shakespeare, everyone. All right, we're all on the same page there. He wrote some plays. They're sort of well-known. You know, some people like them. Anyway, and I was so excited. It was a life-changing role. I was going to have flowers raining from the sky. It was going to be brilliant. And then, no. Dreams crushed. I bemoaned my fate to the heavens. Can you tell I'm an actor? Yeah. I know. I'm so subtle. I'm so subtle here. Can you believe my parents were surprised when I told them I wanted to be an actor? Yeah, right? When I was little, I used to memorize children's books and perform them for my parents and their friends, like Goodnight Moon and stuff, and the story of all the little children's books. I would, like, do huge performances for my parents, and they were surprised when I said I wanted to be an actor. I was like, do you know me? No. Anyway, so what have I been doing during this time that we've all been separated? I've been sitting at home, I've been eating a lot of pasta, I've been trying to converse with my cat, who I have to tell you is not the best rehearsal partner. No. No, I'm there trying to do Shakespeare, and she's kind of looking at me like, meow. And then she just walks away, which is great for learning how to deal with rejection. Not so good for rehearsals. Not so good for rehearsals. But then I had an idea. I thought, in the show, Prospero has all these spirits do his bidding, you know, to create storms and do his laundry. I don't know. And I thought, what if I had some rehearsal spirits? Yes, that's where you guys come in, you see? So will you be my rehearsal spirits and we can sort of get into this show and explore and play around a little bit? All right, yes, okay. Let's get ready. Let's get ready to get into some acting, some serious Shakespeare. Okay, everyone, let's take some deep breaths. Deep breaths. Everybody ready? Here we go. In. And out. And in. And out. And one more for safekeeping. In. And out. Yes. And then like a big stretch. Yeah, get your bodies waking up. Move around. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Ooh. Ah. Yeah. Oh, feeling good. Feeling ready to act. Okay, The Tempest. All right. Wonderful play. Shakespeare's last play, all about the closing of stories, the ending of things. Also appropriate. And I really love it. I really love the play. It's rather beautiful in its way. It sort of celebrates some uniqueness and some innocence and a wonderful idea of the journey and being changed and transformed and potentially realizing that the outcome you thought was what you wanted was not actually what you wanted. Really, really beautiful. Lots of beautiful thoughts in this. But one of the moments I particularly like is the beginning, because it has this beautiful moment of symmetry between the characters on stage and the audience. And it's done this way. So at the beginning of The Tempest, there's a big storm, right? Everything's going crazy. You have lights, you have sound, you have actors running around on stage, absolute chaos on stage. And if you're a character in that scene, you have no idea what's going on. It's absolute craziness. This storm has come up out of nowhere, right? And if you're the audience, the curtain opens on this scene of chaos and you're like, what's going on? If you've never seen the show before, what's happening? So you and the characters are in the same headspace, if you'll pardon the pun. You're in the same boat, as it were. I'm sorry, I promise. Not too many of those, I promise. Please stick with me. And it's lovely. It's a beautiful moment because immediately the characters, the actors, and the audience are having this emotional experience together. They're experiencing the same feelings and emotions. I think that's lovely. I think that's something so wonderful that can happen in theater. So let's start there. Yes, exactly. Let's start there. Let's start with the ship, okay, and the storm, Tempest. So we need some sailors. Some sailors aboard a ship. You, my friend, you have the look of someone who's always yearned of a life at sea. Up you go. Hello, sailor. All right, and you back there. You back there. Yes, you. I can see it in your face, the call of the ocean. Voila, there you go, and you over here, yes, you, I knew it, I could sense it. There you go, sailor you are, done, hello sailors. All right, my friends, you guys are going to help me. We are going to be the special effects crew, okay? We're going to do it old school, like they did back in the day, well, sort of. We're going to just use lights to create a lightning effect. There you go, and I've got one more over here somewhere, there we are. Where's my little friend there? Here you are, my friend. Flashlight for you. Oh, they want to... Oh, hello, there you are. Don't worry. Here you go. Here you go. Take this flashlight. There you go. All right, now practice, a little practice run. I want you to point those up at the balcony there with our sailors in their ship. Very much like the globe, you know? Got this beautiful balcony. And shake them around and create kind of a lightning effect. Shake it. Or flick them on and off. Yeah, go for it. Don't be afraid. Go for it. Oh, nice. I like it. Oh, yes. Very good. Okay, good. But first we're going to start with a sunny day. Sunny day. So let's have the effect of a sunny day. There we go. Lovely. All right, sailors. It's a beautiful day at sea. The sky is clear. The birds are out. This is why you became a sailor. The ocean is calm. It's wonderful. Maybe you're singing a sea shanty. Yes, okay. Farewell and adieu to you Spanish ladies. Farewell and adieu to ladies of Spain. For we've received orders to sail for old England. We hope in a short time to see you again. And then, all of a sudden, a great storm sweeps up. Oh, waves as tall as the ship itself. Crashes of thunder, flashes of lightning. It's a strange, unnatural storm. Almost as if, spoiler alert, by magic. Yes, and the ship is pitching here and there. The bosun is calling out orders above the storm. Hi, my hearts! Cheerily, my hearts! Tend to the master's whistle! Bring in the topmast! Blow till thou burst thy wind, if room enough! And the storm's getting worse! The ship cracks! Oh, all may be lost! Yeah! Lower! Lower! Bring her around to try the main course! But to no avail. The ship is torn apart by Prospero's magic. The instrument of his revenge, and all aboard her are presumed lost to the waves. Wonderful. Come on back down, sailors. That was fabulous. That was fantastic, my sailors. Let's have some snaps for our wonderful sailors. That was beautiful snaps. Yes, well done. And of course, some snaps for our special effects crew. Sailors, snaps for your special effects crew. They were brilliant. That storm, woo, thrills and chills, my darling. Thrills and chills, real theatrical magic. Speaking of magic, oh, nice, I like it, that's beautiful. Yes, very symbolic, I like it. That's a very lovely image with the wheel and the flame. Yes, very magic. Oh, yes, well, as I said, speaking of magic. You know, what one of the oldest forms of magic is thought to be in the world? What people think of as magic? Pop quiz. We all have one right now. You all have one. Yes, masks! They were thought to be a type of magic, right? They're transformational. You place a mask on your face, and suddenly you become something other than what you are. You become different. You can become a symbol, an idea, a god, an animal, and they're used. They've been used in rituals and storytelling since time began, really. Transformational, yes. So maybe we can use a bit of that magic to get a little deeper into the story. Here, everyone take one of these. Pass these round. You wouldn't mind, so everyone gets one. There you go. Pass it round to everybody, so everybody gets one. Yes, don't worry. Everyone's going to get one. There you go. There you go. Do we have, where'd you go? Oh, there you are. There you are. There we go. And one for you, my dear. There you are. Wonderful. All right. Now, I sense I have some experienced spirits among you. Some of you who know the ways of the magic. Would you perhaps demonstrate my spirit right here? And everyone do what they're doing. So take off your mask. Place the stick atop it. So grasp your mask with that lower graspy button. Grasp it. There you go. And now place the stick atop it. Very good. Very good. And now snap with your free hand. Let the stick go and snap. And circle counterclockwise. Circle counterclockwise. Very good. But in the wild waters to roar, the sky, it seems, would pour down stinking pitch, the sea mounting to the welkin's cheek, a brave vessel, some noble creature within him. Poor souls. Oh, well done, my spirit, thou hast performed exactly to the point the vessel that I bade thee. There's more work, for by accident, most strange, bountiful fortune hath mine enemies, to my shore. Now go. Make thyselves like a nymph of the sea, unseen to any sight but thine and mine, invisible to every eyeball else. Go take thou this shape and approach. My spirits, come. I am ready. I boarded the king's ship. Now in the deck, now in the waist, in every cabin I flamed amazing. The fire and cracks of sulphurous roaring, the most mighty Neptune did seem to besiege and make his bold waves tremble. Yea, his dread trident shake. Not a soul among them but felt a fever of the mad and played some tricks of desperation.
all but mariners plunged into the foaming brine. Then, all afire with me, the king's son Ferdinand, with hair upstanding, then like reeds, not hair, was the first man who leaped and cried, "Hell is empty, and all the devils are here!" No one got lost at sea. All body parts here and accounted for. Excellent. Good, good, good. Welcome. This is my home away from home, I suppose. Prospero's cell on the island where he was marooned with his daughter, Miranda. Not a happy story, really. Prospero was betrayed by his friend and his brother, Antonio. And I've sort of tried to assemble what I think are important bits and pieces of Prospero's life as a way of getting in touch with his character. Right. As a person, we collect mementos, don't we? We collect pictures and important little memories from trips, songs even, things like that, pieces of art. And we fill our house with them. And these are ways of getting to know us. These are things that have meaning for us. And so as an actor, it's very useful to try and discover what object would have meaning for your character. And why? And so I've sort of done that here. I've kind of collected some objects that are important to Prospero. So if you pick one up and bring it over to me, I'll tell you a little bit about it. Yes, and with the text, it reminds me of all of these pieces. Ah, my soup pot. We'll have some stew after the story. How about that? Yes, very good. Ah, books. Yes, that's a good place to start. Books. This was the beginning of it all, you see. It's true. With help from the Kingdom of Naples, my brother Antonio did usurp and set me to sea with my daughter Miranda. For study's sake, I had cast my government upon my brother, and to my state through stranger being transported and wrapped in secrets evidence. Me, poor man, my library was dukedom enough. Temporal royalties, he now thought me incapable. See, Antonio believed that I was not fit to be duke. Ah, this is a good reminder. I keep this to remind me of Antonio. You see? Yes, my brother, Antonio. The dukedom of Milan was mine by right. But through foul play, we came from thence. My brother, Antonio, did claim the dukedom for his own. My own brother, having both the key of office and the office to set all hearts in the kingdom to what he needs him. Now that he was the island, which I hid in my princely trunk and sucked my venture more. Remind me, you can't even trust one. Ah, the ring of state. Very good, very good. Yes. Oh, well. My brother, Antonio, made an alliance with the Kingdom of Naples. So dry was he for sway with him to give him annual tribute, to do him honor, subject his coronet to his crown, and then the dukedom. As yet, untouched. Bless him. The most ignoble stoop. He gave our give them away. We were free. Ah, very good. Yes, my spirit. Very good. Well, it was all legal, wasn't it? Any horrible things are legal.
We must obey. Poor brother. Yes. My deceitful brother, being thus lorded, not only with what my revenue yielded, but with what my power might else exact. To credit his own lie, he did believe he was indeed the prime duke. Out of the substitution. My spirits. Well, money was the cause, obviously. He wanted more money and more power, didn't he? My brother. Did claim the dukedom for his own, with all the honors thereon. My brother, treacherous honor, levied. And one midnight, fated to the purpose, did Antonio open the gates of Milan. And in the dead of darkness, the ministers for the purpose hurried thence, me and my crying daughter, Miranda. Oh, Miranda, where, there are her shoes are here. There, her little shoes that she wore. Yes, oh, yes, Miranda. I have done nothing but in care of thee. Thee, my dear one, who art ignorant of what thou art. Knowing not whence I am, nor that I am more than Prospero, master of this poor cell, and I know better. I wonder, did Antonio hate me so? My own brother. But, it is as they say, it does not dwell in sadness. For you are here, and I have company now, and the time is right for my revenge. My enemies are all here within my grasp. Yes, exactly. We have brought them all to my shore. Alonso, the king of Naples, Antonio, my brother, Sebastian, the king's brother, and the king's son, Ferdinand, who is crucial to my plans. Yes, I have them all written down on that list there. Have I got them all? Did I name them all? Yes, excellent. Sometimes in my memory. They are all here. At last, my spirits. Ah, spirit. Take that staff, and you, find me that bottle there. I'll show you the very beginning. Yes, excellent. It's here that I preserve my most precious memory, the memory that is the key for all that is to come. You see, my people provided our escape aboard a rotten carcass of a ship. Neither sail, nor tackle, nor mast it had. The very rats instinctively had quit it. And there they hoist us, to cry to the sea that roared to us, to sigh to the wind, whose pity sighing back to us again did us but loving more. Here we are, for so many years ago, but the time, as I said, is at hand for my revenge. Spirit, with the list, we've done step one, haven't we? We've brought all the enemies here to the island. Excellent, check. Put a big check mark there, would you? Very good, thank you. All right, spirits, are you ready? Are you ready for phase two of my four-part, brilliant four-part plan for revenge? Yes, I'm ready, you're ready. But first, perhaps, there we go. Excuse me, I, all that talk of water and ships and sailing, I just really had to pee. So enjoy some marshmallows, toast them up in the fire, enjoy the gooey goodness, get your strength up, I will be right back. Concentrate sometimes when you really have to pee. How are the marshmallows? Yummy? Good times. Anyone else have to do a quick bathroom break? There's some toilet paper behind that bush. Nope, you're all good. Okay. Oh, did we lose one? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh no, there you are, spirit. Hello. You're up there. Ah, okay. What are you doing all the way up there? Come on back down, Spirit. We've got revenge to do. Oh, you've got something? No? All right. That's all right, Spirit. We're on to the revenge. We're on to the revenge. Is everyone ready? Everyone sugared, sustenated, ready? All right, let's bring it in, and we're going to go 1, 2, 3, revenge. Okay, everyone? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, revenge! Yes! Ooh, beautiful day for revenge, I know. The island, the weather changes, it's all quite magical. Yes, all right, Spirits. Okay, as I said, phase two. Where's my checklist, Spirit? Phase two, we're ready for phase two. Yes, okay. Phase two, and it is really genius. Remember I said I had a daughter, Miranda, and the king has a son, Ferdinand. And they are of a similar age. Yes, so what are we going to do? We're going to get them to fall in love. That's right. Yes, thus ensuring my legacy and the future of Italy. What? Genius. I know. Thank you. It's almost as if I had years and years alone on an island. Think about it. Yes. All right. So that's what we're going to have happen. So I've been feeling that one of you very close to me. I sense that we have a familial connection right here. Everybody say hello to my beautiful daughter, Miranda. There she is, Miranda. So sweet and so fair. So lovely beyond compare. I just made up your theme song. Isn't that great? I know. Miranda theme song. All right, Miranda. Now, we need a Ferdinand, but we're going to let you choose your Ferdinand. Yes, because it's a modern day, and girls get to choose. I'm not going to force a Ferdinand on you. You can choose your Ferdinand. So I'd like you to look at all these beautiful sprites here. All these beautiful sprites. And from amongst them, let's have them do a nice princely pose or something, yes? From amongst them, choose a Ferdinand. Oh, you too, my spirit. Yes, get in there, get in there. Get in the prince competition. Yes, all right, do a nice princely pose. Yes, ta-da. Okay, Miranda, you get to choose. Ooh, with the rose, I see. All right, well, that was a smooth move. Smooth move, spirit, very nice. All right, you, Ferdinand, get a hat. Yes, and you get a theme song, because that's what we do here. You get Ferdinand, Ferdinand, the greatest prince in the land. It's Ferdinand. And we have so many times, we have so many sprites here. Maybe we have two sets of Ferdinand and Miranda's. Yes. Yeah, because it's fun. Why not? All right. Miranda. Right here. Yes. You, my spirit. Yes, are you feeling it? Are you feeling Miranda-y, lovely and beautiful? Yes, you are. I knew it. Miranda, there she is. All right, Miranda, you must choose a Ferdinand from these three. All right, three. Do your prince. Oh, you're helping them out. Nice. You're sneaky, using the rose. Very good. There you go. All right, princes, what are you going to do? Ooh. Onion, rose, what do you choose, Miranda? Onion? It's a good choice. Onion is stable, it's healthy, it can be made into a lot of things. Oh, you take the onion. We have our Ferdinand right here. Yes, Ferdinand with the onion Ferdinand. Ferdinion, Ferdy, all right. Yes, very good. And now my two lovely spirits. You are important as well. I need you. You are crucial to my plans. Oh, thank you, Spirit. You are so sweet. That's so nice. All right, my spirits. Okay, now, you guys are crucial to my plans. We've got to make these two fall in love ASAP, okay? So you're going to need to perfume the air with love juice. Yes, like it's glitter and beautifully scented. I need to, yes, oh, very nice, spirits, very nice. And I'll sign each one of you to a Ferdy and Miranda. So you over there, you're this Ferdy, and Miranda, you here, this you're in charge of these two, okay? Good. That way we'll divide and conquer. Okay. Everyone, oh, spirits, you didn't get a theme song. Do you want a theme song, spirits? Yeah, okay. You're simply the best spirits in the land. Simply the best. Spirits in the land, you're simply the best. Yes, there we go. Who wants to live in a world without theme songs? Not me. All right,
let's get this love scene started. All right, all right, all right. Miranda's, my dearest darlings, my lovely daughters. You are young and innocent and beautiful, okay? But you've never seen another human being before, let alone a man. So this is all very shiny and new. Let's have you two stand over there by that tree. The two Mirandas, very good. And we'll have the spirits. Why don't you stick with the Mirandas for now? Because you're going to lead them into the scene. Very good. All right, Ferdies. Do you mind if I call you Ferdies? All right, Ferdies. Listen to me, guys. You are princes. You are handsome and young and brave and bold. But at this moment in the play, you are very depressed. Yes. Yes, because you believe your father and everyone aboard the ship is lost, and you are the sole survivor, and you are alone on this island. This deserted island. I know, at least you have each other. That's true, at least you have each other. All right, Ferdies, let's have you bemoaning your fate by this tree over here. Yes, by this tree over here. And just be bemoaning your fate. All right, Murdies and Ferdies. I know, right? It kind of works. All right, Mirandas, you're going to enter the scene. The spirits are leading you because they are in on the plan. Spirits, you are in on my genius plan. All right, ready? And you look up, Mirandas, and you see... what is? A spirit? I might call him a thing divine, for nothing natural I ever saw so noble. And Ferdinands, you look up, and you see this beautiful vision before you, and you say... Most sure the goddess on whom these heirs attend. Oh, you wonder. Be you made or no?
No wonder, sir, but certainly a maid.
Oh, heavens! My language? I myself am Naples, who ever since at ebb with mine own eyes beheld the king, my father, bereft. Ooh, that's a bit rough, wasn't it, Spirit? Ferdinand had a bit of word vomit there. Yeah, he got so overwhelmed by Miranda. He was like, oh my god, she speaks Italian! Amazing! And I'm Naples, and I just saw my dad die. Whew, that's a lot for a first date. I know, you're like, not smooth, Ferdy, not smooth at all. But it's okay. Miranda's into it. There's love juice in the air. This is like that moment in a movie when time slows down and they see each other across the dance floor, right? Let's give it a try. Everyone move in slow motion.
I can see you calling in the air tonight. Oh, Lord, I can hear you calling in the air tonight. Oh, Lord.
Beautiful. Yes, what a magical moment. All right, so all is going well with the love juice. Prospero's over here going, yes, they are now in each other's powers. But this swift business I must uneasy make, lest too light winning make the prize. All right, spirits, you are no longer love spirits. You are attack spirits. Take Ferdinand's prisoner. Take them prisoner. Yes, and the Mirandas are like, no. Oh, she fainted. She's so upset. No, nothing ill could dwell in such a temple. That was very dramatic, Miranda. I liked it. I've never seen that before. That was excellent. All right, Mirandas, go to your room. Go. Go to your room, Mirandas. Yes, go. Just do it. I said so. Because I'm your father, mother. Yes, go. All right. Yes, so now we put the Ferdies to work. We've captured them. Ferdies, you're going to clear this clearing of debris. And my spirits are going to watch you and make sure you do it. Okay, clear the clearing. Right, but you, spirit, secretly... Wait, you. You're going to let the Mirandas out of their room secretly. Don't tell them I told you to. Okay, go, go, go. All right, so the spirit secretly lets Mirandas out of their room. This spirit is guarding, making sure everything's happening on schedule. This is my schedule spirit, so they've got the checklist. They know what's happening. All right, so the Mirandas are let out of their room to go and look at the Ferdinands, who are working hot in the hot sun, probably shirtless and sweaty. All right. And you go to your Ferdinand, Miranda, and my love spirits are watching and making sure the love juice starts to flow. And you say, alas, now I pray you, work not so hard. If you'll sit down a while, Miranda, your Ferdy is over here. I know, I know. Yes, come. There she comes. Here she comes. I knew she'd make it. All right. Oh. Alas, now I pray you, work not so hard. If you'll sit down a while, I'll carry your logs to the pile. No, precious creature, I had rather crack my sinews, break my back, than you should such dishonor go while I sit lazy by. Oh, you. You, so perfect and so peerless, are created of every creature's best. Good job, spirits. Turn up the love juice. Miranda, do you love me?
Aye, beyond all limit of what else do I love, prize, and honor you.
I am your wife, if you will have me.
My mistress, then, and I thus humble ever.
My husband?
Aye, with a heart as willing as bonded heir of freedom.
Ooh, that's a good line. Good job, spirit.
Well done. That was beautiful. I've never seen such powerful love juice.
So good. Amazing.
Really? Oh, my gosh. It's so beautiful. I'm going to cry. You made me believe in true love again.
Oh, my God. Beautiful. All right, checklist, spirit. What do you think? Can we check that off the list? Phase two, big check?
Excellent. All right, guys, onward to phase three. Ah, phase three. Phase three, which is punish the baddies. Because, I bet you didn't know, but on the other side of the island, those who betrayed me, the rest of the crew, they did not drown. No, they are alive and well and being evil. We have, of course, the ringleader, the master of all, my brother, Antonio. Yes, booze. Yes. My brother Antonio. Yes, of course. And we have the King of Naples right here, the King of Naples, Alonso. There he is. Hello, Alonso. Everyone bow to the king. Thank you. Now, Alonso, you are actually feeling remorseful. You're feeling bad about everything because you believe your son is dead. So you're pretty sad and broken up about it. No, Antonio, you're not a good friend. Antonio, you're like, what is this? Kings are not supposed to have emotions. What's going on, man? So what does Antonio, my treacherous brother, do? He goes to the king's brother, Sebastian. Yes, and he says, hey, Sebastian, what's up, my dude? What's up, my bro? You are looking very kingly these days. Very kingly indeed. I have an idea, just a thought, and I'm just spitballing here, but what if we murdered your brother while he slept and you became king? I know, right? Yes, it's like the freaking Sopranos up in here. And is Sebastian a good brother? Is he? I ask you, audience, is Sebastian a good brother? No. Sebastian is like, sounds good, dude. Yes, let's do it. So now every time that, I know, Alonso, I know what's going on. You thought your brother loved you? No. But now every time Alonso falls asleep, all right, Alonso, be asleep for a second. These two, like, sneak up behind him, start to try and murder him. Alonso wakes up, whoop, and they're holding swords, and they're like, we heard a noise? Yeah, a big noise, big scary noise. This is what happens in the play. It's like a farce. Oh, my God, we were protecting you. That's what we were doing. That's why we have these big things. Yes. So that's going on, and then we also have the court drunks, Trinculo and Stefano, just having a merry old time. Yes, you guys are just having a grand old time. Oh, no. Are we missing a spirit? Did we lose one of our own? Oh, no. Poor spirit. We mourn you. We mourn your loss. Hopefully you will find us somewhere in the mist of time. Come back to us, spirit. Come back to us. Hopefully the MC will have mercy and grant your presence to us once again. All right, but we can't dwell. We've got to move on. We've got a lot happening. There's a banquet to attend. It's in the middle of nowhere. Don't be worried about it. Don't ask so many questions. Come on, it's just a banquet. In the middle of nowhere.
Come on, you are mad, no sir. frozen in fear at the sight of Prospero's horrible harpy. Yes, frozen in fear, my dear. Prospero's keen, bravely figure of this harpy had outperformed my real. They are all in my power, and in these fits I leave them while I go to bid young Ferdinand and his and my loved daughter.
Ooh, right? Isn't that harpy pretty cool? Love it, one of my favorite things. Well, Spirit, what do you think? Phase 3, punish the baddies, check? Yes? Good job, good job. All right, now phase 4, a wedding! Yay! Everybody loves a wedding. All right, let's bring back our Miranda and our Ferdy. Yes, and I think one of the spirits, our poor lost spirit, was a Miranda, wasn't she? Poor thing. All right, but we had a Ferdy. Were you Ferdy? You were Ferdy. Yes, Ferdy. All right, Ferdy. Well, Ferdy, would you like to choose a Miranda? Can you get a Miranda? Yes, this one here? All right. Aw, Miranda. You get to be a Miranda. It's okay, my darling. You get to be a goddess. You do. You get to be a goddess. You get to be, in fact, Juno, queen of the goddesses. You are here to bless these unions. Yes, you're my friend. We're besties. I got a goddess squad. It's great. You are here to bless this union. Oh, but spirits first, maybe let's clean up the garden a little bit. We had a rager here last night. You remember that little lovely restoration spell that we did earlier with the ship? We can do that here. If you grab some branches near the trees, place them atop your mast, snap and circle. Put it on top of your mask, Spirit. Nice. Oh, that's perfect, Spirit. Very nicely done. You've got the knack of this. Here you go. Look at that tree. Can you try some of these ones here? Oh, the garden's already looking good. All right, give a snap. Give a snap and a circle. Snap. The snap with that top grippy button. Place the stick on there. Snap. Top button. Oh, you got it. Oh, you let it go and sit there. You want it to stay on the mask. And snap away. Snap separately so you don't grab it. There you go, and then you would circle. But yeah, good. You see? You see? All right, let's see if we can get here. We'll help you out. Here we go. All right, come here, Spirit. Yes, you. That's right. Come here. Come here. There you go. All right, so take your mask. Take your mask off. Grab it with that lower button, that lower. Come on back. It's all right. It's all right, you're doing beautifully, and you look gorgeous. There we go, so grab... grab your mask with that lower button. Grab the mask there. There you go, you got it. And bring it down, now we put the stick on top of it. Now with this hand, snap about here. Give that top button a snap. The top button. So not the low. There you... Oh, yeah, there you go. Nice! Well done! You did it! All right, spirits, the garden is looking beautiful. Let's go over to the wedding arch, my spirit. The wedding arch. All right, Mirandas, let's have you stand by the arch, my dears. Miranda's birdies wait here with Juno. All right, Miranda. Yes, upgraded Miranda. Come and stand by the arch with the other Miranda. You two are going to stand by that arch there. Okay, Juno, you're going to lead our Ferdies to the Mirandas as you bless them with happiness. Yes, yes, you Juno. And fidelity in the marriage. All right, are you ready? So here we go. Honor riches, marriage blessing, long continuance and increasing, hourly joys be still upon you. Juno sings her blessings on you.
Well, mazel tov. You may now hug your person. Everybody hug.
Oh, no. Give it. Come on. Do your meringue. That's right. Everybody hug your person. Yeah. Oh, come on, Juno. Bring it in. Come on, Juno. Let's hug. Yes. Yay. Everybody's hugging. Hugs all around. Oh, all has been made right through marriage. The good have been rewarded. Oh, thank you. And the bad have been punished. And with that blessing, we must return. Ah, we're back. Back at the beginning where we began, my spirit. But perhaps a little, dare I say it, transformed by our journey. As I said, masks have a wonderful transformational property, so if you hold out your mask, you will see that indeed you have been transformed by this moment and by our journey together. You are now a part of my story as I'm a part of yours. Thank you all so much for being a part of my story and for sharing this moment in space and time with me. It's been a real wild ride. And I know some of you have been here for a large part of the journey and some of you only briefly. But I thank you all very much from the bottom of my heart. It's been a true honor and a privilege to perform for you. Truly one of the highlights of my career. When I was young, I told my mother that I wanted to be a performer because I wanted to change the world and do something that affected people, that really affected them. And I think with this show we have, and you are all a part of it, it wouldn't have happened without all of you, so thank you all so much. So let's raise our hands once more as we gather the Tempest for the last time. Our revels now are ended. And these are actors, as I foretold you, are all spirit and are melted into air, into thin air. And like the baseless fabric of this vision, the cloud-capped towers, the gorgeous palaces, the great globe itself, and all which shall inherit shall dissolve and leave not a rack behind. For we are just as dreams are made. And our little life is rounded. Thank you all so much. You've been absolutely wonderful. Come on, bring it in. Bring it in, my friends. Let's have a post-show hug. Yes. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you all so much. You're absolutely wonderful. This was a delight. You were beautiful performers. Yes, come on. You were beautiful performers. It was so lovely. And I truly enjoyed it. It's a wonderful gift. A wonderful gift. So thank you. Come on, let's dance it out. There's no cure that dancing can't provide. Yes, absolutely. Work it out. Every culture in the world has dance. And they have. It is one of the universal languages. It binds us all together. So this is the way to end the show. What? Thank you all again, my friends, my wonderful, wonderful companions. You are all fantastic. You, the audience, that have been under my charge. Now, to the elements, be free and fare thou well. Thank you. Once again, I'm Whitten. I adored having my final show with you. It was a true honor. Thank you all so much. Thank you. Thank you so much.